friends, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to explain you about software and its different types. First, I will begin with software. Software is a set of programs that enables a computer to perform a specific task, whereas hardware is a physical component. In order to make use of the hardware, we need or we must install a software. Without a software, we cannot drive or cannot use a computer or any mobile devices. Let's see the types of software. Software is broadly classified into two categories, namely system software and application software. System software, it is used to control the overall operation of the computer system, whereas application software is used or to perform a specific task. Now we will see the software and its different types. Software is broadly classified into system software and application software. And the system software is again categorized into two types, that is operating system and utility software. Whereas application software is categorized into two types, that is for general purpose and one more for specific purpose. We will see one by one. Operating system, it is an interface between the user and the computer hardware. In this figure, we can see that whenever user sends an instruction or a command to computer, then operating system make that command such a way that must be understandable by a computer. When the computer receive that command and it process it and reply to a user through operating system. And here also operating system make that output in such a way that must be understandable by a user. In this way, the operating system act as interface between user and the computer. This operating system is also used to manage the computer hardware's software resources, and it also provides the common services for the computer program. Whenever we buy any new computer or any cell phones, we must install a operating system. Without installing the operating system, we cannot install any other application program. Hence, the operating system sits on the top of the software hierarchy. Few examples of the operating systems are Windows, Linux, iOS, macOS, Android, and Chrome OS. We know that Windows is very commonly used operating system in the PC, desktop, and laptop. And whereas Linux is one more example of operating system, this is open source operating system. iOS and macOS is made by Apple company. This iOS is used in mobiles, whereas macOS is used in Apple computers. Android is one more popular operating system, is very much used in tablets, cell phones, now even in TVs. Chrome OS is one more operating system made by the Google. These are all the symbols of different operating systems. This is symbol of Windows, this is symbol of Linux, and this is symbol of Fedora, one more flavor of Linux, Ubuntu, macOS, and this is symbol of Android. Now coming to the utility software. This type of software usually used to maintain the good health of computer. And it is also used to analyze, configure, optimize, or to maintain a computer. It is used to support the computer infrastructure. We'll try to understand this with the help of its category. The utility software is further categorized into three types, namely system utilities, file management utilities, storage device management utilities. In the system utilities, the example of system utilities are antivirus, firewall, registry checker, package installer, and the explorer. We know that antivirus is a software which is used to remove the viruses which are entered from internet or any external devices into a computer or any cell phones. Whereas firewall is also a software which is used to filter the data which is coming from internet or any network. Registry checker is a software which is used to maintain the database of an operating system. Similarly, the package installer and the explorer of the example of system utilities. As far as file management utility is concerned, The software backup tools and the compression tools are example of it. Software backup tools, it is used to take the backup of the software. Whereas file compression tools are used to reduce the size of files. In case of storage device management utilities, disk cleanup, partition management, formatting, disk space allocation and defragmentations are the example. Disk cleanup is a software which is used to remove the residual files or unwanted temporary files which is created on the hard disk. Similarly, partition management and formatting, disk space allocation and defragmentation softwares are used for the hard disk. Whenever we buy a new hard disk, we have to create the partition on it. The partition, namely C, D, E, F drives. In order to create that partition, we use partition management. In order to allocate the space, we use disk space allocation software. And once we create the partition, allocate the space, in order to format that drives, we need formatting software. Formatting is a process which creates the number of tracks and sector so that the user can store their information. Defragmentation is one more software which is used to bring the scattered data together. Now coming to the application software. Application software is categorized into two types, that is general purpose and one more is specific application purpose. General purpose application software is developed keeping in the mind the general needs and requirements of the large number of the people. Some example of general purpose application softwares are word processing software, spreadsheet software and presentation software. We know that in order to type any letter, we use word processing. In order to make any Excel sheet, that is spreadsheet, we use spreadsheet software, that is MS Excel. And presentation software, we use PowerPoint presentation. These three softwares comes under the package of MS Office. Similarly, in case of database management, we use DBMS softwares. In case of desktop publishing, we use DTP softwares, namely Adobe Photoshop, Acrobat Reader, CorelDRAW. These are all the example of DTP. Similarly, the graphic softwares and multimedia softwares are also example of general purpose. Here we can see that the symbol of different general purpose software, that is MS Word, Excel, PowerPoint, database management, similarly Netflix and the email, Google Drive. These are the few example of application software, that is general purpose application software. Now coming to specific purpose application software. These softwares are developed keeping in the mind the specific requirement of organization or individual. This is meant for a specific application. We'll try to understand this with the help of few examples. The software which is used to issue the ticket at airport and railway stations is an best example for a specific purpose application software. Similarly, the software which is used to produce a salary bills or payrolls at any organization, and the software which is used to maintain the stock, that is inventory control, by any organization is also an example of specific purpose application software. And the billing software which is used at the supermarket is also an example of specific application software. Now coming to the latest trends, that is open source software. The open source software, the name itself indicates it is open for all. These type of softwares are maybe available free of cost, and its source code is available to everyone. What is source code? Source code is a code which is used by developer to develop any application, and this source code is available to everyone. Any organization or individual can use this source code and they can customize the software according to their need. They can also improve the software, and this source code is also used to fix errors. The few examples of operating systems are shown here. Linux is an best example of open source operating system, that is Ubuntu is flavor of Linux. This software can be used as an alternative of Microsoft Windows 10. Android is an best example of open source software. It is more often used in smartphone and tablet computer. OpenOffice is also an example of open source software system. It can be used as alternative of MS Office. Mozilla Firefox is web browser. It can be used as alternative of Internet Explorer or Google Chrome. Audacity is sound editor. GIMP is image editing software. It is also open source software. Instead of using Adobe Photoshop, we can use the GIMP. Similarly, VLC is also an example of open source media player. These are all the few symbols of open source software. This is for Android, this is for Mozilla, this is for the Linux, and this is for Ubuntu. Now it's time to ask few questions to our viewers. Please write your answer in the comment section of this channel. What are the benefits of open source softwares and what are the disadvantages of using open source softwares? Dear users, I hope that you like this session. If you like this session, please subscribe, like, comment on my channel. Thank you.